WebSportsRadio.com in association with KBFL proudly presents Missouri State University Ice Hockey. With the call, here's Steve Kasson.
And live from MediaCom Ice Park in Springfield, Missouri, it is Division III hockey action as the Missouri State Ice Bears, 18-8-1, 6-0 in the Maca West Silver, play the Robert Morris Peoria University Eagles, who are also 6-1. Hello, everybody. Steve Kasson, Dan Dow. Let me correct myself. The Ice Bears are 6-0 in Maca, and Robert Morris 6-1 with yesterday's loss. So Maca games, these are very important between these two teams. But for Missouri State, it's important to keep the number 9 ranking in the Division III Pacific standings. Dan, you had a chance to watch this team yesterday, and you know, I had a chance also to talk to Chris Peek, and I asked him, I said, is Missouri State the kind of team that likes to trail early and spend the rest of the game coming from behind? And he looked at me and he said, you know, honestly, he says, this is a team that won't give up. It's a different mentality this year. If they do get and fall behind, which they have many times this season, it's not an issue for this team to come back. Robert Morris, on the other hand, came out playing and flying strong yesterday. They got a couple of quick goals to take a 3-1 lead, and Missouri State had to battle back.
Right, and usually we saw with the few games that we did last year, it was almost a deficit for this D3 club was an automatic defeat in their eyes, but a much better club this year, a well-rounded club, and very consistent club. That's why they're in where they are in the rankings. That's why they've had success this year. And it all starts with their top line of Tyler Venneri and Sean Leslie. Their duo has been outstanding this year.
And you look at some of the goal scorers, including Michael Humey, 20 goals on the season. Sean Leslie with 20 also. And but after that, you kind of have a drop-off. You have Tyler Ranieri with 11 goals. You can't look at the output in that respect and say, okay, this team doesn't have a very potent offense. They still do. There's guys throughout the lineup that are getting goals, and they're getting a lot of assists too. The Ice Bears can put the puck in the net. The key is how they get those chances and those opportunities to do it.
Yeah, and I think a little bit has to do with their scheduling too. They've had a couple D2 opponents with SLU earlier in the year where they got shut out, and facing Lindenwood, Belleville, which by all means were a 5-2 loss and a 5-1 loss, but if it weren't for a period, that game, those two games could have been a lot closer in my mind.
The Ice Bears will have a senior recognition ceremony coming up momentarily. Ryan Gannon, their captain and forward out of St. Louis. Chris Peek, as I mentioned, their forward out of Springfield. And Steve Fontana, defenseman from Whitby, Ontario, Canada. So they'll have a short presentation for that, which we'll have for you. But if you look at especially the Pacific Division, and I had a chance to talk to Jim Sanchez, the head coach of Robert Morris Peoria, and we had a discussion about the Pacific region being so big. And the interesting thing about it is, even though it is so big, where are regionals? In Chicago.
Right. And you look at Robert Morris Peoria with them not even being ranked, you can't say that they're not a quality club. They had a very tough game last night. We're in it until about 7 minutes left when Mike Cummings scored the game-winning goal on the power play last night. And really, a lot of their losses this year, you look at a couple they've had to Iowa State, were a 5-4 loss and a 4-3 loss, and Iowa State's in the top six. It just seems with Robert Morris Peoria, if they had a couple bounces go their way, they might have a shot at regionals at this point in the season. Unfortunately for them, they don't.
A milestone happened in yesterday's game. The first female in Missouri State hockey history to score a goal, Sarah Sabo, gets a goal for the D3 team.
Yeah, you should have told her to save it for today or tomorrow.
Well, she was waiting for it. She has a couple assists on the season. In fact, Sabo with 1 goal and 3 assists now, the freshman 5'9", 150 out of St. Louis.
And she hasn't even played a full season, so from a defensive standpoint, that's pretty impressive for a point production output.
And I did have a chance to ask her. I said, so did you know you had it on your stick? She said, yes. And she said she wasn't even concerned with scoring the goal per se, just getting it towards the net, and it went in. And, of course, the scene on the Ice Bears bench, they were mobbing her, and I'm sure fans in attendance had no idea what was going on. They see a group of players huddled on the bench while the game's going on, and that was all to congratulate Sarah for being the first female to score a goal in Missouri State hockey history.
And I don't think anybody was happier than her defense partner, and Andrew Fugner, who hugged her at least three times before they even got to the bench. So a great surprise and a pleasant sight to see all around.
Well, we are ready for the introductions of the two teams. Let's head on down to Tim Greasy, the public address announcer.
Springfield, Missouri, home of your Missouri State University Division III Ice Bears. This afternoon, the D3 Ice Bears take on Robert Morris University out of Peoria, Illinois. And the starting lineup for Robert Morris is as follows. Starting at right wing, number 18, Zach Buncey. At center, number 6, Cam Bernicke. Left winger, number 7, Dylan Durham. The right defenseman, number 4, Phil Edwards. The left defenseman, number 44, Sam Milligan. And in goal, number 29, Cam Heron. That's Robert Morris University's starting lineup. And now, your Division III Missouri State University Ice Bears starting lineup. Starting at left defenseman, welcome number 26, Stephen Fontana. The right defenseman, number 14, Jonathan Schwartz. At left wing, number 7, Troy Cordy. At center, number 11, Ryan Gannon. At right wing, number 19, Mark Jones. And in goal, number 1, Keith Parker. Ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon, the Ice Bears are proud to recognize and give our fans the opportunity to recognize our outstanding senior Ice Bears players playing their final home game here at Mediacom Ice Park. Our thanks to these Ice Bear seniors for giving us the privilege of seeing their great talents over the years and their skills that they've displayed over their Ice Bears careers. Thanks for all your hard work and dedication to our program and for all you have given us during your playing career. The Division III seniors, we have 4 that we'll be recognizing this afternoon, including number 26, defenseman out of Whitby, Ontario, Canada, Steve Fontana. Also, number 10, a defenseman from Peoria, Arizona, Tyler Ellis. Now, Tyler is a senior. However, he is deciding on whether or not he will return to the Ice Bears program next season. Thanks to Tyler. Also, we have number 11, Ryan Gannon. Ryan's parents are here with us today. They are Holly and Steve Gannon. Welcome them to the ice. Ryan played four years with the Ice Bears. He's out of St. Charles, Missouri. He went to high school at Francis Howell North. And Ryan is a marketing, sales, and marketing research degree. Ladies and gentlemen, our thanks to number 11, Ryan Gannon. And our 4th senior, welcome number 8, Chris Peek. Chris's parents are here with us as well, so welcome to the ice, Michelle and Alan Peek. Chris also has played 4 years with the Ice Bears. His hometown is Springfield, Missouri. He went to Kickapoo High School, and Chris has majored in marketing and sales management. Also, by the way, today is Chris Peek's birthday. Happy birthday to Chris Peak. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, please join us one more time. Give an Ice Bears round of applause for these seniors. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to raise the roof.
All right, we're just about ready for the first period of action here. Steve Kasson along with Dan Dow. Thanks for tuning in on Web Sports Radio. As Missouri State will skate from the left to the right, Robert Morris from the right to the left. And we are just about ready for hockey to get started here at MediaCom Ice Park. Ryan Gannon for the Ice Bears coming in to take the draw with Cameron Bernicke. Bernicke, one of their leading scorers for Robert Morris, 13 goals, 9 assists, and off the draw. The puck will be taken in front of the Missouri State bench. Quickly, Robert Morris, Phil Edwards gets tripped, and we're going to get a penalty immediately off the draw. The Ice Bears touch up, and just 14 seconds into the game. Well, Dan Dow, we had the over and under yesterday of 3 minutes in when the first penalty would happen in the game. Well, if we would have bet today, we would have won. It's a penalty to the Ice Bears, Steve Fontana.
I think Fontana just trying to get his stick in for a poke check, accidentally got Bernicke's skate. He goes down in an early power play for Robert Morris, and it looks like Mario Sanchez is going into, or initially looked like he might have been going to the box. Refs say, no, you can go back to the bench. But at any rate, a big point for Robert Morris here early on to establish a lead, see what they can do here.
Opponents are 19.9% on the power play against Missouri State. And off the draw, the puck is cleared, and quickly the Ice Bears will have control. It will go to Ryan Gannon, who will let the puck go. Now he'll play defense. Brandon Neville will have control for Robert Morris. Get it across the line. And it'll come in the zone. A big hip check. Zant Bunce is checked hard by the Ice Bears' Andrew Fugner. It'll go to the far side. Fugner to chase, helping to keep the puck into Sam Milligan. Milligan looks on the right side, spins around, has an opportunity. He shoots, and it gets deflected high and wide to the near side. 1:23 to go on the power play for Robert Morris. High slot. It'll go from Neville now to the right side again to Sam Milligan off of his stick, but holding it in is Nick Bussey, and he'll go to the line for the line change to the bench. Still kept in by Sam Milligan and Robert Morris. On the ice now is Joe Dobbelary, and Dobbelary gets a shot. Here is Phil Edwards with a blast that's blocked down. The Ice Bears have control. Here is Sean Leslie, 22 goals, 11 assists on the season for him. And it's stolen by Cordy. Cordy, as losing his stick, was Cole Metzler. Now Cordy gets wrapped up along the far side. Metzler's there, and Cordy will let it go. But a good effort by the Ice Bears. And Troy Cordy, 10 goals, 15 assists for him with 3 power play goals this season. Cordy to steal the puck. Looks for help, nobody there, so Cordy across the line. He's 2-on-4, gets a shot in, and a save by the goaltender. Cam Herron is the goaltender for Robert Morris. Herron is 7-3 with a 2.90 goals against average, a 768% save percentage. He does have 2 shutouts this season. Keith Parker in nets for Missouri State. Parker is 3-4 with a 4.18 goals against average and an 895% save percentage.
Same 2 goalies in today's matchup as opposed to last night. Herron nearly facing 40 shots. Missouri State had an empty net goal to finish off the game, but a great game by Herron. Had to stand on his head, had a lot of quality chances for this D3 Ice Bears squad.
Cameron Bernicke to carry it into the Missouri State zone. It swept to the far side. Blake Maxwell in to cut it off. It comes up the middle, and a backhander in, saved by Parker on the backhander by Dylan Durham. It'll go behind the net. Robert Morris with Cameron Bernicke gets a pass over to the right side. A shot by Zach Bunce is sent to the near side boards. Now Cameron Bernicke again as the power play is over. 17:38 to go in the period. Blast in, and then Sam Milligan shot steered aside by the goaltender. Keith Parker saw it through some traffic, got his right leg pad out. Puck intercepted, Missouri State out of their own zone. Jonathan Schwartz got his first goal yesterday for Missouri State. It'll be cleared out and taken by Milligan. Sam Milligan of the Eagles. He breaks free, left side, save, rebound, and Parker was able to cover it as it went underneath his left leg pad, and he'll hold on.
Well, Milligan, the freshman, 6'2 out of Brantford, Ontario, looks a lot bigger than 6'2 with his skates on, but you have to keep an eye on him if you're Missouri State. On the point, had a slap shot in last night's game from outside the point that Parker nearly missed and misjudged, and that almost went in with a rocket, just hit the corner of the post, nearly had a goal for him, but has a rocket on the point, so you have to be careful not only when he's on the ice, but especially when he's on the power play.
Off the draw in the Missouri State zone, won by Robert Morris, taken by Brandon Neville, but he lost it, and the Ice Bears will have control. They have a 3-on-2 slowly into the zone. Here comes Mario Sanchez. Shot hit the outside of the net. It'll go to Troy Cordy. Cordy gets it to the far side, intercepted by Robert Morris, taken by Matt Deluski, and he'll get it out in front of his own bench. Robert Morris with control, but it's turned and we go the other way. Ryan Gannon, captain for Missouri State, swings around, gets around two, now has it on the right, left faceoff circle. Gives it, and a shot by Troy Cordy is steered aside by the goaltender Cam Heron. Far side boards along the goal line. Sanchez is down, tries to poke it ahead to Gannon, now gets it back to Sanchez. Checked off in the corner by Matt Deluski. They'll go to the near side, intercepted by Nick Bussey, and he'll give it to Deluski for Robert Morris. The Eagles can't clear it. Now they finally do as it's tipped out to center. Steve Fontana will shoot it back in. Stopped by the goaltender, Heron, with 16:13 to go in the period. Full line change for Missouri State. Banked off the glass and cleared out to center. And Duran Yankee will send it in for the Ice Bears. Yankee played a little bit for the Division II team last season. Puck is cleared out to center, and it's sent into the zone where Parker will steer it aside and give it to Yankee. Technically, he's still playing on the Division II team because Yankee's jersey is being shared with Connor Millard of the Ice Bears, who wears number 3. And I feel sorry because they both have to share the jersey without it being washed.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. From what I've been told, they don't wash that stuff in between games, so that's going to be a pretty stinky, pretty smelly jersey that they have to share between the two.
Especially, well, it works both ways because Millard wore it last night, and then Yankee had to wear it afterwards.
He uses it prior on Friday nights, and Yankee gets the benefit of the doubt of wearing it first on Saturdays.
And that's assuming it's washed today. Play continues.
One would hope.
Ice Bears had control of the puck. It'll go to Ranieri. He'll send it up right side, now to the left side to Hummy, and he's not able to get control of it. He was checked hard from the stick of Phil Moulton, and we go the other way. Across the line in the Missouri State zone. Here is an opportunity, and getting pulled down is Eric Ostrovics. Goes to the point, it is cleared out to center. And Robert Morris with control, and Jacob Schweder. Schweder gives it the left side to Blake Maxwell. Maxwell will send it in, swing it all the way around. Parker will let it go with a forecheck. Now to the far side, we get a whistle and a stoppage in play. And with 15:03 to go in the period, we'll have a faceoff. Should stay in the Missouri State zone.
A huge stick lift there by Moulton for Robert Morris on the near end here, as Tyler Ranieri for Missouri State able to cycle the puck in front with Hummy being the only man all alone, but Moulton there to get the stick lift and get the puck away just in time.
Puck is dug out by Zach Bunce. Now it'll go to Schweder with a drive that's behind the net. Chasing it down is Cameron Bernicke. Bernicke once again to the right side to Schweder. Drive in that gets deflected up and out of play. And a faceoff with 14:45 to go in the period stays in the Missouri State zone.
Something that we haven't really seen tonight as often as we did early on last night is a lot of physicality. There's quite a bit of feistiness between the two clubs in the first meeting last night. I don't know if these teams are just sore and doesn't want to dish out as much as they wanted to from last night, but at any rate, a little bit less physical than the night before.
Drew Sturm to chase it down, but not able to hold it onside is Brandon Olson. And with 14:38 remaining, we will have a face-off just outside the zone. Well, you know, I talked to both coaches, head coach B.J. Norman of the Ice Bears and Jim Sanchez of the Eagles, and because I really am short of time, and I'm just going to phrase it this way, the teams tend to play down to the other team. And it seems that way with Missouri State, but yesterday with Robert Morris coming out as strong as they did, the tempo stayed high throughout the game.
And that's what kind of surprised me this year with McKendree University against Missouri State. They had four meetings this year. All of them were decided by one goal. But as opposed to last night, a much better job and style of play from the D3 Bears.
Ice Bears try to clear it out of the zone. They can't. It's held in. Right side drive, just missing wide off the stick of Brandon Neville. Now a follow-up in front is blocked. DeWiski got the shot, and the Ice Bears break out a two-on-one. Gannon to keep it going on the left side. Gannon with it. He shoots, save, rebound, and not able to put it home was Mario Sanchez. 13:50 to go in the period. Far side boards. Cordy's there for Missouri State, dug out by Robert Morris. And a great opportunity by Missouri State, and an even better pair of saves by Cam Heron. Full line change for Robert Morris. Ice Bears get it across the line, offside. Cordy in too soon. Face off with 13:34 to go in the period, and still no score.
Well, one guy that can play a bigger factor today as opposed to last night is Mario Sanchez, 28 and white, usually a forward. Had him play quite a bit of defense last night, and because he's back at his forward position, able to use his speed a little bit more. The incoming freshman that came in just at the beginning of the semester should be an exciting player to watch in the upcoming seasons.
Ice Bears again break it out, and it'll go to Ranieri. He'll try to get it to Hummy. It's deflected. Stays in the zone, though, as Andrew Fugner couldn't hold it in. We come the other way. Two on one for Robert Morris. Leading it is Ostrovic. He gets a shot off, and it goes wide near side boards, and it's cleared out to center, where Robert Morris with a bouncer in off the stick of John O'Neville, and it goes to the far side. Opportunity for Brandon Neville to send it in, both brothers. And a line change for at least one of them. Puck comes the other way, left to right, Missouri State. Puck comes in the zone. Now it will be intercepted by Robert Morris. They'll have control, Blake Maxwell. 3 goals, 11 assists for him on the season. Here's Dylan Durham. He has 5. Gets a shot in. It's deflected to the near side. 12:42 to go in the period. Shots are 3-4, or 4-3, actually, in favor of Robert Morris Peoria. Broken stick in 3 pieces. The referee moves it out of the way. Play in front of the Missouri State bench. Cleared out to center. Maxwell for Robert Morris Peoria. We'll pick it up. Send it ahead to Schweder. Drive in. Pad save by Parker. Ice Bears with a line change. 12:19 to go in the period. We're in the first, and Robert Morris and Missouri State knotted up. There's no score. Shot in, save Parker off the stick of Schweder. Rebound, and Parker covers up. Now we have some pushing and shoving and high sticks going on. Officials quickly in to break it up. Referee Mike Oliva and Mike Casagrande. The linesman is Joe Murphy. And apparently we will have at least one penalty, maybe more, as the officials are coming over, and I think maybe one each, Dan?
Well, I thought Fugner might have been one, or maybe Schwartz that had a little extracurricular activity, but looks like it's only going to be one for the Eagles. And an opportunity for Missouri State on the power play, who didn't score last night. The penalty kill for the Eagles, very good at moving around, which is usually what you, from an offensive standpoint, what you want to do. But for the Eagles, that's really their advantage, as we saw in last night's game.
Well, it'll be a slashing call against Cameron Bernicke, and the Ice Bears on the power play. Missouri State this season on the power play, 24.8%, 31 power play goals for 125 opportunities. Chris Peek comes in to put a check on his man. That's Sam Milligan. And a scrum forward to the left side. Dug out, picked up by Missouri State. Andrew Fugner with a backhander, intercepted. And Sam Milligan will go one on two. Milligan for Robert Morris. He breaks free. Milligan looks for a shorty. He shoots, save, rebound. It's loose. It's in a skate. And it moves into the corner. It was in Fugner's skate. And now an Ice Bear gets dumped. We're going to get a penalty against Robert Morris.
Be Milligan that's going off, because he tried to go for the rebound while the puck was tangled up in Fugner's skates. A great opportunity, as neither Fugner nor Parker knew where the puck was, but a little too advantageous by Milligan, and a great opportunity for Missouri State to get on the board here with 11:34 remaining in the first period.
Tripping will be the call, and it's a two-man advantage for Missouri State just after Robert Morris came also close, if it wasn't for the skates of Andrew Fugner. He skated around, and as he did that, skated in a circle, he kept the puck out of the net. Now Fugner with an opportunity. He'll go to the right faceoff circle, return pass as it comes to Leslie. Leslie walks to behind the net, looks in front. Leslie's pass is corralled by him again after it was blocked partially by Nick Bussey. It'll go to the left side. Working now to Hummy. Drive in, pad save, rebound, peak, backhander right through, couldn't get it to Ranieri. It'll go to the far side. Now Fugner, high slot, blocked in front. Good block by Phil Edwards. Here's Hummy, another block, and it's cleared by Neville, but not out. Here's Hummy. He'll work on the power play. Two-man advantage for 49 seconds. No score here in the first period. Steve Kasson, Dan Dowell. Thanks for tuning in. Dan Lee's later on.
He'll be with us later, yeah.
Yeah, here's a shot in front. Saved by the goaltender, Heron, as right on the doorstep was Stephen Fontana, and they're going to call him for a penalty.
Yeah, Leslie's going to go off.
Or Leslie, yeah, that is 16, not 26.
Had a little late poke check, and they're probably going to call him for interference on this one, so that'll negate the 5-on-3 opportunity. But a lot of credit going to the Eagles defense. They were crouched in right in front of Heron, but having Neville block a couple of shots, a great job by him and a great job by that penalty kill to draw a penalty and cut the deficit and eventually get a power play out of this.
I think the official call was a cross check.
16, Sean Leslie, 2 minutes for cross checking. Leslie, 2 minutes cross checking.
That's the call from public address announcer Tim Greasy as the Ice Bears work with less. With more ice, less players, but they still have the advantage. Fontana brings it into the zone, gets it to Cordy. Now Cordy works to Fontana on the right faceoff circle. Steve Fontana, high slot, swings around, looks to try to get around the stick check of Zach Bunce. It is through, but not the skates of Brandon Neville, and it's cleared all the way down. Now it's a 4-on-4 as Robert Morris gets one back for 30 seconds, and then it'll be a short power play for the Eagles.
And a well-deserved rest for Neville, a great penalty kill that he stayed out the entire time for.
Here come the Ice Bears. Troy Cordy, 10 goals for him. Cordy will get cut off at the pass by Phil Edwards. Now he'll give it to Fontana. Right side, blast in into the midsection of Heron. He'll hold on. 9:46 to go in the period. 12 seconds remaining until it will be the second power play for the Eagles.
I think Fontana, they're just trying to shoot it out low, look for a rebound off the pad of Neville, ended up closing the wickets through the five hole and making a big stop there as we're just past the halfway point of this first period.
Full line change for both teams. Tyler Ranieri coming in to take the draw for Missouri State. Cameron Bernicke for Robert Morris, and they finally get it straightened out as far as the players go. So now they're going to have to change the faceoff players. So it'll be Brandon Neville, and he wins it. Phil Edwards to the near side, but the Ice Bears hold it in. Schwartz tipped in front by Peak, and a big save by Heron. He was waiting for that one. Now it's a power play for Robert Morris. Ice Bears are shorthanded for 47 seconds. 9:30 to go in the period. Poked away by Ranieri. He has it for Missouri State. He's checked into the corner by Edwards. Phil Edwards has some help from Bernicke. Cameron Bernicke to dig it out, and it comes up the middle, intercepted. Robert Morris will clear it out of their own zone. Across the red line, now to the blue line. Right side, stopping up is Bernicke. He'll give it to the side to Milligan. It's poked away and cleared out. Ice Bears with a quick line change. 20 seconds remaining in the power play. Robert Morris, get it in the zone. Here's Sam Milligan. He will swing it all the way around and give it to Brandon Neville. Neville has his pass cut off behind the net, cleared out to center. Here might be a break. Here comes Cordy, Tyler Cordy. Oh, and he has his stick knocked out of his hands as he tried to cut away. Good check by Jacob Schwier. That was a legal check, and that also stopped a potential break. We're going to get a puck coming all the way down. Icing will be the call as the power play had expired. So just expired, and now we're going to have icing face off back in the Robert Morris zone.
Well, if it weren't for the protective netting in front of the stands,
we would have had a souvenir.
Yeah, Cordy lost his stick as a great hit.
Now, the key is, Dan, did you get a good shot of that on camera?
I'm kind of hoping I did. I wasn't paying attention, but I got the hit in. I don't remember if I got the stick or not.
Shot by Andrew Fugner is stopped by Heron, and he'll hold on. 8:35 to go in the period. And still no score. Shots are 8-6 in favor of Missouri State, but still no score on the board.
That's not a common theme, as we saw last night with Heron almost facing 40 shots. Seems more up to the challenge today. Had to make quite a few stops yesterday. Not as many quality chances for Missouri State because of the great back check by Heron's teammates on the defense, but at any rate, still trailing in the shot count.
Puck is cleared out to center. Sarah Sabo with her first shift on the ice, scored her first goal, and her first goal as a female member of the Missouri State Hockey Organization in yesterday's game. Puck is cleared now with 8:11 to go in the period. Full line change for the Ice Bears. It'll go to the near side boards. Coming in is Sabo. She'll put a check on Eric Ostrovics, and it's cleared out to center. And the Ice Bears will regroup in their own zone. Mike Hummey out of St. Louis, Missouri. 21 goals for Missouri State this season. Leads the team. Puck is cleared in, and it'll be swung to the far side by Phil Edwards. Off a stick, it stays in. Ranieri, he'll give it to Hummey. Blast in, it's blocked partially. Leslie's there. Hummey will wait for Leslie to try to get control. Good forechecking, and it is held in. Ice Bears have it. Now here's a shot off the stick of Duran Yankee. It'll go to the far side. Yankee to hold it in. A bouncing puck, and he can't control it. Taken by Ostrovics. It's cleared down as Robert Morris with a line change. 7:18 to go in the period. And the puck is cleared out to center. And back now into the Robert Morris zone. Sam Milligan, he'll set things up. Milligan to Brandon Neville. Neville on the right side. Neville trying to get around the check of Mario Sanchez. Sends it right through the middle and through the slot. It's deflected into the corner behind the net. Looking forward is Nick Bussey. Bussey tried to bank it off of somebody up the slot. It'll go to the right side. Blast in, save Parker. The shot from Milligan. Here's another opportunity, and Parker steers it aside. Sanchez to clear it to the point. Kicked ahead by Sam Milligan to Robert Morris. He'll get it to Nick Bussey. Here's Bussey with a shot in. Save Parker behind the net. Near side. Off the glass and held in by Jean O'Neville. It's cleared out to center. Neville will get it onside to Cole Metzler. Metzler tried to get around the defense of the Ice Bears. He'll drop it back, looking for an opportunity for Sam Milligan. Gets it right through the crease, nothing doing. Puck is still held in, though. Good pressure by Robert Morris. 6:10 to go in the period. Behind the net to Cameron Bernecki. A drive from the slot that's missed high by Joe Dobelier. It'll go to the left side, a shot that's blocked. Taken away and still held in. Behind the net, now right side, up the middle, kicked off of the skate of Bunce, and it's out to center. Shot in by Leslie as the Ice Bears go for a line change. Puck to the far side. And now in the half boards of Robert Morris zone, it's Dylan Durham to bring it up the middle, but it's stolen. Shot, score! Spinning around is Brandon Olson, and he gets it from about 10 feet in front of Heron, and the Ice Bears take a 1-0 lead.
Well, quite a bit of momentum on the Eagles' part as they had a couple great shifts, but Missouri State able to get the puck deep a little bit, get the puck to Olson in front, fires, beats Heron, high glove side, maybe not as much as he wanted on the shot. Maybe that confused Heron a little bit, but nonetheless, a 1-0 lead for Missouri State with 5:32 remaining in the first period.
That is Olson's first goal of the season, and we'll wait to catch the assist from Tim Gracie, the public address announcer. But it's 1-0 Ice Bears. So play continues in the Robert Morris zone now off the faceoff. And it'll go to the corner. Mark Jones on the ice. Jones to put a check. And the Ice Bears with control. Schwartz, he'll send it ahead as far as the red line. And it's back in the Missouri State end. 1-0 Ice Bears. Puck taken by Phil Edwards. Edwards
Ice Bears goal scored by number 27, Brandon Olson. Assisted by number 8, Chris Peek. And number 17, Drew Sturm. Olson from Peak.
So that's the call as play continues. It's behind the Ice Bears net. Parker looks at it from the side. Intercepted and taken by Missouri State. Schwartz will send it in, and the Ice Bears will go for a line change. Robert Morris quickly calling for it to come up, but it's stolen by Hummey. Puck is intercepted now. Taken by Nick Bussey, and he'll control it on the left side. Gets around the check of Andrew Fugner. And he'll swing all the way around to the right side. Gets it up the middle and off the stick in the corner of Brandon Neville. Robert Morris with control. Cole Metzler behind the net. Metzler centers it in front. A backhander that hits a skate, stays behind the net. Now to the right side, off of the stick of Milligan, and the Ice Bears intercept. They get as much as clearing it out to center. Quick line change for Missouri State. Nick Bussey will send it in for Robert Morris, and the Eagles will line change. 3:47 to go in the period. Ice Bears come in offside. Leslie touches it as it was off of the skate of Jean O'Neville, and we'll have a face-off. It'll stay outside the zone. So because the puck hit the net of Jean O'Neville, it was just enough to make the four Ice Bears that were waiting to pounce on the zone made them go offside. Peek had it for Missouri State off of his skate, comes back onside and sends it into the zone. Now 3:45 to go in the period. 1-0 Missouri State. Chris Peek is there. He gets checked hard by Cameron Bernicke, and we're going to get a whistle and a stoppage in play. 3:27 to go in the period. 1-0 Ice Bears on the first goal by Brandon Olson. Chris Peek and Drew Stern with the assists.
I've liked the offensive pressure that the Eagles have had in the later stages of this period, but they have to get more men in front of Keith Parker, as he's been spitting out quite a few rebounds as of late. They've been shooting it low and they've been hitting his pads, and he hasn't been able to corral it just yet.
Brandon Olson had control of the puck, but now we're gonna go whistle for a hand pass, I believe.
Yes.
So the faceoff will stay in the zone. 3:16 to go in the period. Still 1-0 Missouri State.
I'm not sure there's a whole lot that Bernicke could have done there unless he wanted to turn the puck over to an Ice Bear. A smart play by him to keep the puck in the defensive zone, but make sure there's a face-off instead of the Ice Bears keeping the play going.
Face-off is won, and Robert Morris with Jacob Schweder to have control of the puck. Robert Morris in front of their own bench, out of their zone now. Zach Bunce. Bunce with a shot that's deflected behind the net. Now Duran Yankee. Yankee lost the puck. Well, the Ice Bears were going to try to get it out of the zone. They lost it, and now they finally will get control. Across the line to Drew Sturm. Sturm with an assist and the only goal for Missouri State. It'll go to the left side, that is. Now to the right side to Sarah Sabo. Sabo shoots, tipped in front by Cordy, and a save by Heron. Boy, would you like to have seen another one from Sabo.
I think Cordy was just trying to jump out of the way. It was more of a coincidental contact that might have hit him in the leg, but at any rate, the puck dropped down right in front of Heron, and a nifty little save by him to keep the deficit at one.
Ryan Gannon in to take the draw for Missouri State, and Joe Doblier will try to win the draw for Robert Morris. It's to the point, and the officials say no, it's offside. So Sabo gets back onside after the attempt to keep it onside. With 2:25 to go in the period. Lead to Bernicke. He'll get to the right side to Walensky. Nicholas Walensky gets a shot. It's blocked into the corner. Chased by Matt Deluski. Deluski's pass comes out to center. And backhanded in by the Eagles. It is deflected up, and that may stay outside the zone. And it looks like the officials say yes, as Phil Edwards got a backhander that hit nothing but net, so to speak. So we'll have a faceoff with 2:08 to go in the first period. And a 1-0 Missouri State lead. They're going to say center ice. Ice Bears to win the draw. Ranieri will. Tyler sees it go in front of the Missouri State bench. Tried to help it further along, but it'll be Missouri State deep in their own zone to try to get things set up. They finally get it out. Now to Tyler Ranieri. Ranieri with a drive in, stopped by Heron. Heron tries to clear it off. It will inadvertently hit the skate of Sam Milligan, but he has the ability for Robert Morris to clear it out to center. Cole Metzler, he had control momentarily, banked off of his stick, and it's at center. Now to go to Mike Cumming with a drive in, right through Leslie's attempt through the slot. Now Ranieri. Ranieri looks for Leslie, instead gives it to Hummy. Spins around, intercepted. Nothing but Robert Morris Eagles. Here's Nick Bussey. Bussey, 2-on-2, looking for Metzler. Intercepted. The Ice Bears have control. They move it down the middle. Leslie, it's too far for him, and it's cleared out to center. Metzler, he'll swing it to the right side. And Parker will stop it with less than a minute remaining in the first period. Puck is offside as Leslie will touch up. Ranieri was bumped by Cameron Bernicke, so because of that, and the offside is called. Face-off just outside the Robert Morris zone. 53.9 seconds to go here in the first period. A 1-0 Missouri State lead.
And I don't know about you, but I'm kind of surprised with the amount of shot totals. Yes, high for even both of these team standards, but they actually had higher between the first couple of periods last night.
Spinning around for Missouri State is Brandon Olson, the only goal scorer here in this game. Olson is taken out of the play. Now Sam Milligan, right side for Robert Morris. He breaks free. Milligan, he shoots, and what happened? Was it deflected out of play? No indication. And
it's
in the glove of Parker. I'll tell you what, he was so innocent with that. I didn't know where the puck was.
And I don't think the referees did for a little while as well, as they blew it a couple seconds after he had it. He had to shake his glove hand a couple times to say, hey, I have the pucks. Play should stop.
Well, I can tell you from experience as a goaltender myself, I'm demonstrous when I make a save. It's this big production to let people know I made the save. Blow
that's,
the whistle.
That's just because your ego's big.
Play continues with 18 seconds remaining in the first period. And Phil Edwards for control for Robert Morris. Puck stolen by the Ice Bears. Comes up the middle. Here's Sabo, a shot that's blocked. And that should do it, though, with 5 seconds to go. Quickly, the Ice Bears want to get something going. It's slapped in the zone by Cordy, but that'll do it for the first period. Shots are even up at 10 apiece after one period of play. 10 on Cam Herron, 10 on Keith Parker, and that's where we are right now after one period. Brandon Olson, his first at 5:32. Chris Peek and Drew Sturm with the assists.
I'm not sure how much more you can say other than that was a fairly even period on both sides. You'd have to say possession of the puck and offensive time between the two clubs are just about even. It's just for Missouri State, they have one goal on the board and they have a 1-0 lead after this first period.
Well, we'll take a quick break, and when we come back, the sounds of MediaCom iSpark, because we have no interviews set up for this game. We'll do that in just a moment. It's a 1-0 lead for Missouri State.
Hi, my name's Scott Morris. I own Falstaff's Local. It's the new hockey bar in town. You're missing out if you don't come and watch some Blues games down here. You'll also be able to hear the sound of all the games. And we're located between the Hers Building and the movie theater on Park Central West. We have a limited but great menu. We're open for lunch. We are the hockey bar, so come and watch all the hockey games. We're going to cover MSU Ice Bears, the Springfield Express, and we may have some big-time NHL players show up. We are installing a train whistle down here. I think we're the only ones in town that are daring to do that. Please come and see us at Falstaff's The Hockey Bar. Thanks a lot. I will see you soon.
Back at MediaCom iSpark, Steve Kass and Dan Dowell. It is a 1-0 lead for Missouri State. And Dan, we talked about rankings. And if you look at the rankings in Division III, again, the Pacific region is one of the largest regions. Colorado State with the number one ranking and 4 first place votes. Arkansas, which will move to Division II or make that Division I from Division III next season, 3 first place votes. Metro State with 2 first place votes in third, and then in fourth, Northern Colorado, Northern Arizona, 5th, Marquette, 6th, which the Ice Bears have beat. Iowa State, 7th, which the Ice Bears split against. Same with Nebraska, Missouri State split, which is number 8. And Missouri State, of course, ranked 9th. Robert Morris University White squad is ranked 10th. New Mexico, 11th. Santa Rosa, 12th. With Aurora Blue, 13th. Air Force, 14th. And Loyola Chicago at 15th. Well, the sounds of MediaCom iSpark here as Dan joins us again. Dan, we're just going over the Pacific region.
Yes.
And you know, again, it's the largest region. You look at it, and if you were right now looking at the South and the North and the Atlantic, we're going to try to pick the teams that would probably make it to Nationals. You kind of have to go with the perennial teams. For instance, Oakland, Hope College, Michigan State, Calvin College, Saginaw Valley, Adrian Gold, Grand Valley. That's all in the North region. They've all made it in successive years. You look at Colorado State. You look at Florida Gulf. Alabama having a great year, number two in the South region. Central Florida, they've all been there. California University of Pennsylvania, number one in the Atlantic. They've been there. Farmingdale, big favorite. Alvinia and Newman, also big favorites. Rowan, they're actually at number 10 now, which is pretty good for the Rowan hockey squad. But if you look at those perennial teams, and you think there are some good hockey in Division III, or there is good hockey in Division III, and you kind of wonder what the future is going to be of some teams like Robert Morris, like Missouri State's D3 squad, which had the opportunity to move up to D2 next year and have elected to stay in D3. But regardless of what you see out there and the way that maybe sometimes the play can be hot or cold, you still have to like what you see out of Division III.
Right, and a big loss for them, though, that we haven't talked about, though, is the fact that Arkansas is moving up from D3 to D1 as well. And they always seem like the powerhouse coming out of the Pacific. But at this, because they were, what would we say, they were a pretty dominant force. They had a stranglehold on the number one seed coming out of the Pacific. But going into the rankings this time around, they were around number three, I believe. So it just proves that the competition at this level is getting much better.
It definitely is. We will leave you with the sights and sounds of MediaCom Ice Park here in the second period, as we're in between with a 1-0 lead for Missouri State. Brandon Olson, his first goal of the season. Chris Peek and Drew Sturm with the assists. Yeah, yeah. Get down to business and skip for play. Hey, yeah.
Fantasy, my head, you'll be screaming, oh.
Back at MediaCom IceBark, Steve Cass and Dan Dow. It is a 1-0 lead for Missouri State. The goal by Brandon Olson, his first of the season. Chris Peek, Andrew Sturm with the assists. And that's where we stand right now. For the most part, a good first period, Dan.
Yeah, both teams competed evenly, but I think from both head coaches' standpoints, I think you have to look more for a physical aspect to this game, not really either team coming out with a lot of heavy hits as they did last night. So look for that to pick up here in the second period.
This period, Missouri State in their white uniforms with the maroon trim will be skating from the right to the left. And Robert Morris, who were waiting to come out. They came out late to start the game, and it looks like they'll be late to start here this period. Coaches are just making their way to the benches, Jim Sanchez and his crew. And here they come, the Robert Morris Eagles, and of course the maroon gold and also the eagle adorned on their chests with the RMU on their shoulders. The one thing I do like about Robert Morris's uniforms is they are trimmed in gold, the numbers are gold, and a little bit of black to separate everything on their jersey so that it's much easy to read, very easy to read, as is Missouri State's. But there are some teams, which we've witnessed, Dan, that it is very, very tough to read their jerseys.
I mean, we already had issues with the Fighting Illini against the D2 squad last night, just to not say that their jerseys are bad, but I don't think we have the greatest perspective at times up in the booth, especially when the puck's on the far end, to try to tell who is who at any given time.
Speaking of the D2 team, we'll have the broadcast of Missouri State's Division II, our normal broadcast, which will be taking place at 7 o'clock tonight, 6:50, with the pregame show on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio, so we hope you'll tune in for that.
And Dan Lee will be back, so we'll have our trio.
That's right.
Back it'll, together.
It'll be Dan Lee. Power plays in the period. Missouri State was 0-for-2, and Robert Morris was 0-for-2. So we're ready here for the second period of action.
A And we'll see for the D3 Bears. Yes, they had a penalty very early in that first period, but after last night, becoming more of a disciplined club, I think they only had two or three penalties last night, had a couple in the first period, but I think at times they seem to be necessary just to keep the play away from Robert Morris, and hopefully they'll try to do a better job of staying out of the box, but here we go with the second period.
And off the draw, the puck will come to the Robert Morris zone. It'll be Sam Milligan behind his own net for the Eagles. They get a return pass and set things up. Look to the far side boards, try to get around to the Ice Bears' Mike Hummey. Hummey thought he had a penalty, so he just let the play go, but the official didn't raise his arm. Play continues. It's in the Ice Bears' zone now. It'll be Tony Schwartz, or Jonathan Schwartz, that is, to get it to Hummey and clear it out to center. Underneath the stick of Tyler Ranieri, all the way down on goal, where Cam Herron will stop it there. So the 11th official shot for Missouri State. And we'll have a face-off with both teams changing lines. 19:21 remaining in the second period.
I don't know, should we consider that a shot even though they kept that up on the scoreboard? That more was more of a clearing attempt slash bank pass off the far boards that just happened to go on net.
Well, it counts against your goals against average in a positive way when you make that save, so sure.
That is true.
Play underway in the Robert Morris zone. Puck will be cleared out to center, and the Ice Bears will see a 3-on-2 for Robert Morris. Far side to Cole Metzler. Metzler cut off at the pass. It was Chris Peek who was able to tip it away. Now behind the net. It'll go to Nick Bussey. Bussey will have his pass intercepted by Drew Sturm, and it's cleared out to center. Sent right in, Robert Morris back onside. They're going to line change here, a partial one with 18:46 to go in the period. Now the ice, Sarasebo for Missouri State. She'll have it to the far side. Get it off of Chris Peek's stick, a shot that's deflected off of the attempt by Blake Maxwell. And it's broken by Missouri State, 2-on-1. Here's Brandon Olson, now a 2-on-2, a follow-up missing wide by Chris Peek. It'll go to the near side. Now a shot that's deflected in. Blake Maxwell on defense. He'll clear it to the far side. Held in, though. Here's a shot tipped and a save. Rebound. Gannon's there, and it's deflected into the corner. The initial shot from Mariel Sanchez tipped by Ryan Gannon. And finally, the Eagles are clearing it, but we'll have an icing call with 18:08 to go in the period. And, Dan, in less than 2 minutes, we have seen a lot of action.
Yeah, much quicker pace and a much faster pace start to this period as the one prior, but a great shot by Mario Sanchez along the far boards in the offensive zone, and a great tip by Gannon. I don't think Herron knew where that puck was because he was expecting it to go low. It hit Gannon's stick and deflected, hit off his shoulder. Luckily for him, they had enough mustard to drop down in front of him.
Ice Bears will gather things as Duran Yankee sends it in, getting a hit from Nicholas Walensky for his efforts. Behind the net, the Ice Bears had it for a moment off the stick of Mark Jones. Puck is cleared out to center. Here are the Eagles. Coming in is Eric Ostrovics, and he gets chopped off the play. He's still there. Coming in to help out for Missouri State is Jonathan Schwartz. It'll go to the far side. Too far for Cordy. Held in and deflected by Missouri State. It should stay in the zone as it was deflected by Ryan Gannon, who does not have his stick anymore.
Well, it was initially Schwartz that lost his stick. And because he's the defenseman, Gannon decided to give him his stick and try going back to the bench to have the defenseman stay back in the offensive zone. Had he tried playing the stick with the stick in his hands, that still would have been a penalty for the Ice Bears, but that's not the case.
Off the draw, the Ice Bears with control. Tyler Ranieri to dig it out, but it'll come as Matt Dulinski will come into his own zone for Robert Morris to clear it in front of the rushing Ice Bear. Front of the Missouri State bench, cleared into the zone. Underneath the stick of Andrew Fugner out of St. Charles, Missouri. The sophomore will swing it around to the corner. Off of Mike Hummey's stick, stays in the zone. Save Parker off Dulinski. Matt Dulinski looks to the left side. Now as Phil Edwards gets a shot, it's blocked up the slot. Backhander in front, and a shot by Bernicke hit the side of the net. It may have gone off Parker and then deflected just to the outside of the net. Ice Bears break a 3-on-2. Here's Leslie. Diving play by Matt Dulinski to break things up for Robert Morris. 6:42 to go in the period. 1-0 Ice Bears on the turnaround spin shot from Brandon Olson. The Ice Bears have a 1-0 lead. That was early in the period. 5:32 remained. I meant earlier in the game, 5:32 remained when he got the shot. Here is Buncey with a drive, and it gets deflected up and out of play by Fugner. We'll have a faceoff. It'll stay in the zone. 16-24 remaining in the period, and a 1-0 lead for Robert Morris Peoria. Or excuse me, a 1-0 lead for Missouri State as Robert Morris Peoria will have the play in the Ice Bears zone.
A great defensive play there by Fugner, getting back on the play, able to lay down on the ice just enough to block the passing zone to make sure the pass doesn't get across, and well enough to block the shot as well as it got deflected into the netting.
Sarah Sabo with her hair flowing behind gets the opportunity, but it's intercepted, taken by Bussey. Drive, save, deflected away by Schwartz. Now Sabo puts a hit on Neville, Brandon Neville, who digs out the puck. Steps in front of Sabo. Brandon Neville looking for an opportunity. Bounces the puck off the boards, far side boards. Dropped in low by John O'Neville. Right side now. It'll be Milligan. He'll swing it in low, trying to get it to Cole Metzler. Metzler around the check of Sabo. Gets it to Neville. Brandon Neville, left side score. Sam Milligan gets the blast past the glove of Parker and into the net. And we're tied up at one, 15-40 to go on the period.
Well, with the blast that Neville has, I was amazed he didn't score last night. Had a couple of posts that didn't work for him. This time it does after it hits the inside of the post, past the outstretched glove of Parker into the net. And we have a tie game early in the second period.
Goal number 15 for Milligan. And we'll catch the assists in a moment from public address announcer Tim Greasy. Meanwhile, a 1-1 game. And it's Andrew Fugner, or make that Steve Fontana, to clear the puck. Back deep in the Robert Morris zone, a bouncing puck that is cleared out to center. And Fontana will set things up. Pass intercepted, but it's chipped away at the red line. Now Ronnie Crockett lost it. Gets help from Ostrovics. It'll come into the corner. Turning and spinning is Mario Sanchez to Ryan Gannon. Here comes Gannon, drive in, a pad save, Heron. Shots are now 15-12 in favor of Robert Morris. Ice Bears spin around. Sanchez swings into the corner. Banks it off to Duran Yankee. Holds it on the line on the left side. Now to the right side. Yankee will clear it to the far end in front of the Missouri State bench. And that's as far as it goes. The Ice Bears with this partial change. 14:37 remaining in the period. And Gannon to put some pressure. Joe Doblier will come to chase it down. And Robert Morris with Eric Ostrovics. He'll send it in. Finally, it's cleared back to the Robert Morris zone. Still no indication on the goal information. We'll wait for that with 14:12 to go in the period. Fugner cuts off at the blue line. Sent in as Sable will come back for Missouri State. 14:03 remaining in the period. Far side boards. Kicked off the stick and the skates of Phil Edwards. Behind now to the stick of Bernicke. It's up the middle. A fanned on shot by Bunce. Zach Bunce couldn't get a hold of it. It's cleared back in the Missouri State zone. 13:48 to go. 1-1 game. Underneath the stick of Fugner. Now to Hummy. Bernicke's there for Robert Morris. Checking is Zach Bunce, and he keeps it in for the Eagles. Ice Bears want a change. They can't do it yet. Robert Morris does get that change. Puck cleared out to center. Leslie's pass comes back in, and a delayed offside is sent out to center, where it'll be chased by Missouri State off the stick of Tyler Ranieri. Not able to be held on the line, though. The Ice Bears are offside. Finally, they get onside. Leslie will backhand it in. 13:16 remaining in the period in front of the Ice Bears bench. Opportunity for Cole Metzler to send it back to his defense. And regrouping is Nick Bussey for Robert Morris. Sends it all the way down. Waved off is the icing. Fontana in his own zone, trying to clear it to the corner. Held in by Nick Bussey. Bussey checked off the play. Now to the left side. It'll go to Sam Mulligan. Spins around. Couldn't get a good shot off. Behind the net. Far
Robert
side.
Robert Morris' goal scored by number 44, Sam Milligan. Assisted by 20, Jono Neville. And number 5, Cole Metzler. Time of the Robert Morris goal, 4:20.
That's the call now with 12:36 remaining in the period. So John O'Neville and Cole Metzler with the assists on the goal by Sam Mulligan, his 15th. We're tied up at one. all the way down in the Robert Moore zone. The goaltender Heron to swing it off to the side. A shot from Troy Cordy, who intercepts the puck, is deflected wide behind the net. Now to the near side from the far side. Once again, an opportunity in front. Ice Bears had an opportunity to get control of the puck. They can't. Here is Ostrovics. He is taken out of the play by Gannon. We come the other way. Troy Cordy steps around Milligan. Cordy with it, centers it. It's deflected into the corner along the half boards. 11:55 to go in the period. 1-1 game. 2-on-1. Now 2-on-2 for Robert Morris. A shot in wide. Rebound to the near side. Going to the bench was Walensky. On the ice now is Schweder, and now we get a whistle and a stoppage in play. And do we get both players, or do we have an infraction here? Looks like maybe just an infraction.
I don't know if there.
No, I think we are going to get penalties.
I thought it was more of an equipment tangle up, but.
That's what I thought so too. It's Duran Yankee going in along with Joe Doblier.
But it looks like both of them are going to go off for holding, as both of them were tied up in the corner together. So coincidental minors. Or actually, no, they'll keep this 4-on-4, so a little bit more open ice for both clubs. And the first stoppage really in a little bit. So a nice resting point for both teams. Something Robert Morris has done better this period than the first. Not afraid to use the backboards behind Keith Parker to cycle the puck around. They're able to get the puck deep and keep the defense of Missouri State guessing where they're going to go. Obviously, the shot back to the point on the goal helped quite a bit, and that's why this game's tied.
Zach Bunce breaks free. Andrew Fugner for Missouri State to deflect it to the corner. It's behind the net. Robert Morris with control in the Ice Bears zone. Cameron Bernicke checked by Sarah Sabo. Sabo scored her first goal for Missouri State. First goal for a female in the Ice Bears organization in yesterday's contest. Puck cleared all the way down, 1:24 remaining in the 4-on-4. 11:03 to go in the period. And the puck is cleared to the blue line, and now Leslie will have control. Sabo, trouble with the puck, and just does clear it. Fugner, lead pass. Off the stick of Bussey. Finally, the Ice Bears get it in the zone, and I think things are starting to slow down a little bit, Dan. Ice Bears having all sorts of trouble in the neutral zone now.
I think both clubs are just having issues getting puck from player to player. Can't seem to pass the puck as well as they did in the first.
Bussey across the line, and that's the good thing by teams adjusting and tightening things up. Bussey, high slot. Now a drive in, missing just wide off of Milligan. A rebound in front, drive, save, score! It is Nick Bussey to get their goal. As the Ice Bears were wondering where the puck went to, Parker was down. And after the initial drive from Milligan, Nick Bussey makes it a 2-1 game for Robert Morris.
Well, it looked like Milligan had the initial shot that hit the outside of the post and hit a Robert Morris player down deep. Fortunately for the Eagles, all four of the Ice Bears were down low, had both defense on the point, able all alone, and luckily Milligan gets the shot off, and Bussey able there to clean up the rebound, just sneaks it past Parker, and Robert Morris has their first lead of the Saturday afternoon.
Ninth goal for Nick Bussey. Sam Milligan should get an assist, as he's the one with the blast originally. The puck stolen, Ryan Gannon, backhander, and a save by Heron. So a good opportunity for the Ice Bears to try to get this one back. Puck is cleared now to the Missouri State zone. Leading it is Bunce with a drive that is partially blocked underneath the stick of Cameron Bernicke. Gets it in front of the Ice Bears slot, and it's cleared out to center. Here comes Gannon. Gannon with it. Penalty's over. Here's a right side drive that gets deflected into the corner.
Robert Morris goal scored by number 40, Nick Bussey, assisted by 44, Sam Milliken, and number 22, Brandon Neville. Bussey from Milliken and Neville. Time of the even strength goal, 9:45.
Now we are 5-on-5 as both teams have come out of the penalty box. 9:12 to go in the period. Mike Hummey, and as Fugner behind the play got checked by Dylan Durham, play continues. Puck dropped in the Robert Morris zone, taken by Gannon. He's down the slot. Gannon, he shoots and he missed just wide. He had Heron moving to the left, his left, and Gannon missed wide. He'll go to the bench. And the puck is cleared by Robert Morris. left or right into the zone, where it will be Andrew Fugner out of St. Charles, Missouri, to clear it up to the corner. Now to Leslie. Along the left side, Leslie gets upended, and do we get a penalty? Yes, we do. A penalty, tripping call against Robert Morris, Jacob Schweer, or Schweeder, and he'll go into the penalty box.
Well, Sean Leslie's not the biggest man on the ice, but his agility and his speed is outstanding for the D3 level, able to try to cut back to the inside, draw a penalty, and for Missouri State a chance to get back in this game after they've had a very quiet second period, just two shots so far in this period.
24.8%, power play number three for Missouri State, a shot by Hummy misses wide, and off the boards it'll be covered by Heron. So we'll dial it all again, face off to the right, as you look at it on Web Sports Radio, left of goaltender Cam Heron.
And that's one thing with this D3 club, a very aggressive power play, having four forwards on the ice. If Hummy usually plays the right point in these kind of situations with one defenseman, in this case Fugner, on the ice.
Leslie gets it in low. It'll go behind the net to Schwartz, and Schwartz will move it to the corner. Now the left side to Fugner. It goes to the right side. Drive and a save, rebound. It's moved off of the stick of Tyler Ellis. Now swinging to the left side along the half boards. That's not Ellis. That is Sean Leslie. Leslie with it. Leslie gets pulled out of the play. Now waits for the left right side pass. He shoots. It's blocked up the middle. Can't hold on to it. Robert Morris with control. Coming in is Blake Maxwell, and that he'll just send it in and go to the bench.
Very smart by Maxwell just to throw that puck where nobody was to kill a lot of time on this penalty kill.
Sent right back in with 7:42 to go. Missouri State to set things up. Full line change for Robert Morris. And puck stolen. Coming in is Buncey, as looking up before he got the shot off was Fugner. And right there on Johnny on the spot was Zach Buncey. Ice Bears still having problems getting it out of their zone. 42 seconds remaining in a power play that is non-existent for Missouri State. Fugner across the red line. Now we'll move it in to get things going to Troy Cordy. Drive in, save, rebound, loose, and the whistle blows.
Early whistle there, but yeah, as you mentioned, Steve, a non-existent power play for Missouri State. Not really trying to get a lot of shots on that, just trying to cycle the puck around and keep Robert Morris moving, but a lot of high pressure situations by Robert Morris produced, and a lot of turnovers on this power play for Missouri State because of that.
Shots are getting closer now. They are 17-16 in favor of Robert Morris. Off the draw with 23 seconds remaining, the Ice Bears have control of the puck. Well, no, it's stolen, that is, and taken away by Robert Morris, cleared off the stick of Nick Bussey. Back into the Missouri State zone. 6:50 to go in the period. Leading it is Troy Cordy. Here's Cordy trying to get around the check of Bussey. He does, but not the stick of Blake Maxwell. And it's sent back by Robert Morris into the Missouri State zone. Power play is over. Lead will go to Maxwell into the zone, cleared and sent back to the Missouri State end. We'll have an icing call here. 6:30 to go in the period. And a 2-1 lead for Robert Morris.
When you see guys on the point, you can definitely tell for Robert Morris who their specialty guys are. You have Milligan on the offensive end and Blake Maxwell on the defensive end playing most of the penalty kill thus far and having an outstanding game on the defensive end on the penalty kill.
6:30 remaining in the period. It's a 2-1 lead for Robert Morris. And off the draw, Yankee gets a shot that is blocked. And it's Schwartz to come back in front of his own goaltender to try to clear the puck. Hummy gets it to Leslie, left side, left faceoff circle, swings around. 6:11 to go in the period. Gets it to Yankee on the left point. Now to the right point. It'll be a drive tipped in front, and it is deflected off Schwartz's drive. Somehow Hummy tipped it in front and it went the opposite way. 2-1 Robert Morris. Mocha League implications here in this game. as each team has 6 wins. The Ice Bears will pick up another Maka game tomorrow against Bradley. Far side along the goal line. Coming into forecheck is Tyler Ranieri. Ranieri gets help from Sean Leslie. 22 goals for Leslie this season. And Robert Morris to dig out the puck. 5:28 remaining in what's become a fast-paced game. We're going to get a whistle and a penalty against Missouri State. And what do we have here? Or is that just an icing call?
Well, I thought it was initially an icing call, but Parker went out of the net to go play the puck. I'm surprised they didn't wave it off then, because I don't think any Missouri State player was anywhere near the puck to try to get that icing called.
That's why I thought. I agree with you. I thought the same thing.
But fortunately for Missouri State, the puck goes back into the offensive zone where Gannon will come in to take the draw against Neville.
5:27 remaining in the period. Steve Cass and Dan Dowell, and as Heron has to make a save, a couple of Ice Bears ready to pounce, including Mark Jones.
Now, I don't know if that was more of Neville winning the draw there or Gannon trying to get a shot off, because that shot went directly in on Heron and had to come up with a nifty glove save there to make sure this game didn't get tied up.
Well, Gannon's going to do it again. He'll step in with Cameron Bernicke, and Bernicke can't win it. Sabo with a shot, and a good save by Heron as Sabo did get that shot all the way through. Here's Fugner with another blast and a save by Heron. It's taken by Cordy. He'll go behind the net. 5:07 to go in the period. The Ice Bears now lead in shots, something they hadn't done in a while. 20-18, but they trail on the scoreboard 2-1. Left faceoff circle, puck is cleared all the way down, and just wide of the net, we're going to have an icing call.
A lot of those shots, though, Steve, have been from outside the faceoff circles, not necessarily the greatest shots, but they've had screens, so they've had to have Heron think a little bit, but he's had to make some very common saves this period.
Well, Dan, normally with the Division II team, we award the Coyote Wingman of the Game. Since this will be a ceremonious award, and now we have 2 minutes on the board for Ronnie Crockett. Now, I don't know what that was, but it's a power play, number 4 for Missouri State.
We'll wait for the call, but I would guess in this kind of scenario, maybe an unsportsmanlike conduct or maybe too many men on the ice for Robert Morris, but like I said, we'll have to wait for the call.
Well, it couldn't have been too many men. The faceoff would have been outside the zone, and in fact, the faceoff, oh, I take it back, it would have been inside the zone because it was a Robert Morris penalty. So, yeah, we'll see from Tim Greasy what the call may be. Meanwhile, the Ice Bears have control. Mike Hummey, left side. Hummey fakes the shot, gets one over the head of Heron, and it's cleared out to center.
That kind of scenario, you have to make sure the puck hits the net, because with the carom as wide as it was, had the puck go outside the offensive zone and just killed about 15, 20 seconds with the puck going to the other end of the ice.
Fugner comes back in his own zone, lost it again. Stolen by Bussey.
It'll
go to the right side. Here's a drive.
A 2 minute and it is two for Robert Morris. Time of the penalty, 15-15.
Well, not sure if that's too many men or if that is something was said on the bench, but regardless, it's a power play for Missouri State, which only has 57 seconds left on it. 3:44 remaining in the period. Leslie is hounded by Bussey. And it's Fugner. Ice Bears finally get things going to Leslie on the right side, left side, that is. He'll come up the slot, cut off, looking for Hummey. Left point to Hummey. He gets a shot off, tipped the wrong way as it hit Ranieri, and it's sent all the way down where Parker will stop it there for Missouri State. Ice Bears trying to figure out who's going to get control of the puck. Now taken by Robert Morris, blast in, save Parker. And with Phil Edwards getting that shot, it reminds me of what happened in the NHL just a couple of days ago, Dan.
With Jonathan Bernier and the Arizona Coyotes?
Yep, right off it was a shorthanded goal to open the period. Took, 5 seconds? Power play is over. It's 4-on-4. Coming out of the box is Ronnie Crockett, and Ryan Gannon will get control of the puck. We come the other way. Here's Cordy. He breaks free, tries to get around Maxwell. Cordy is pulled away from the play. Brandon Olson to pick it up. But Robert Morris out of their own zone. They'll have it left to right. Coming free is Doblier with a drive that's blocked into the corner off the stick of the goaltender for Missouri State, Keith Parker. Far side, boards now to go to the left side to Olson. Here's Brandon Olson, sends it in. Missouri State with a full line change. 12, make that 2-10 to go in the period. Shots even up at 20 apiece.
I'm curious if Doblier didn't know he had a man streaking down the far side there. He shot the puck low. I was expecting him to go far pad to see if Parker would have kicked out a rebound for another goal opportunity.
Here's Doblier again. Let's see if he tries it again. 2-on-2. Schwartz to cut him off with the pass. It goes behind the net, where Duran Yankee will have control. 1:45 remaining in the second period. Schwartz, he is pulled down by Doblier, nothing doing, and Doblier then meets Chris Peek at center ice. That's as far as it gets, as the Ice Bears will have, with 1:32 remaining in the period, the opportunity to send it in and go for a partial line change. Don't forget, the Ice Bears Division II team against Illinois comes up at 7 o'clock tonight. We'll have it for you. Blast in off the stick of Bunce, saved by Parker, blockered it into the corner. Now up the middle, a shot that's partially blocked. Bernicke got that one. Robert Morris with some good pressure. Off the glass, it'll stay in the zone. Bernicke, he's there. Coming in front of him is Storm, and he'll get it out to center. Chasing it is Mario Sanchez. Too far for him, as Schweder will come in for Robert Morris. Less than a minute remains in the period. And Sarasebo lost the puck. Sliding down and getting control of it is Bussey. He'll swing it over to the slot, and it is deflected into the corner. Net's dislodged. The official will go ahead and put that back on its moorings. He's satisfied. Play continues. 36 seconds remain in the period. 21-20 are the shots in favor of Robert Morris. Sabo will swing it to the corner and will chase it, but it hits a skate, comes out to center. Sent to Cameron Bernicke. Bernicke steps in front of Sabo. Sabo on her knees trying to get something going with 15 seconds to go in the period. Cleared out to center. And a Fugner. Fugner looks at the clock, shoots it in. 9 seconds. Here's Hummy. Shot in and a save by Heron. He'll cover up. And I got to tell you, about 2.5, maybe 3 seconds ran off the clock there. Officials don't catch it. So with 3.8 seconds to go in the period, faceoff in the Robert Morris zone with less than 4 seconds to go in this period.
For Missouri State, I don't think the end of this period could come fast enough. A lot of jelly legs. It looks like players seeming to be a little bit slower as the period wore on, especially in these kind of situations as the period expires. But usually in these deficit situations is when they play their top line quite a bit of Ranieri, Hummy, and Leslie, and they were out there quite a bit. So you have a lot of guys playing quite a bit and a lot of guys on the bench for long periods of time. Got to keep these guys fresh and wear down Robert Morris a little bit more instead of trying to wear down yourselves as a team.
Cam Heron faces 11 shots, 2-period total of 21. Keith Parker faces 11 shots, 2-period total of 21. Power plays, Missouri State is 0-for-4. Robert Morris is 0-for-2. We did have a couple of coincidental minors, and we had a couple of extra penalties. One was assessed to Schweder, and the other one was assessed to Crockett. Well, Crockett came in on the bench minor. That's the difference in the power play opportunities. So the Ice Bears had some opportunities. In fact, they had at one point a five-on-three, two-man advantage. They could not take advantage of that. We'll see if Missouri State looks back at that and wonders what they could have done. But it's a 2-1 lead. Nick Bussey's ninth for Robert Morris, Sam Milligan, and Brendan Neville also with the assist, and that's where we stand after two periods of play. Well, we'll take a break, and when we come back, more sights and sounds of MediaCom Ice Park right here. With a 2-1 lead for Robert Morris.
Park Children's Academy is a faith-based early childhood education center located at 1108 North Robertson in Springfield. We offer the curriculum and social experiences that will give your child a notable advantage upon entering kindergarten. Monarch offers weekly classes for preschoolers in dance, gymnastics, and soccer. We're visited monthly by the Friends of the Zoo, and the three meals we provide daily are made fresh from scratch. Call 417-831-8732 or stop by 1108 North Robertson behind the courthouse and beside City Utilities in Springfield to schedule a tour today. And be sure to like us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/monarchkids. Monarch Children's Academy, where your child takes flight.
Running. Let's head for the third period. Here's Steve Kasson.
2-1 in favor of Robert Morris as the Ice Bears make their way onto the ice. Dan, we saw the comeback yesterday for Robert Morris, or for Missouri State against Robert Morris. And it was a third period comeback. Is there another one for this team tonight?
Well, if they do, they have to get their power play started. They've been able to draw penalties for the most part in this series, but have had absolutely nothing to show for on the power play. Robert Morris's penalty killing has been outstanding, putting a giant goose egg on the power play for Missouri State.
Yeah, both teams, for the most part, are 0-for on the power play.
But it's one thing to get chances on the power play, and then it's another thing that what Missouri State's doing. They've really only been cycling the puck, and when they've been shooting the puck, it's been from outside the faceoff circles and not really anything in the slot to make Aaron, the goaltender for the Eagles, work at all. He's just been able to watch him come to his glove, come to his pads, and make the easy stop.
The Ice Bears finishing up their meeting in front of their bench, and we'll get ready for third period of action here. So a big, important period for both teams. Of course, Mid-America Collegiate Hockey Association implications here in the Maka Silver Division, West Division. And Missouri State this time will skate from the left to the right. Robert Morris from the right to the left. Ryan Gannon, Cameron Bernicke. And off the draw, the Ice Bears will have control. Sarah Sabo off to Troy Cordy to the corner. And behind the net where Cam Heron will swing it to the corner. His goaltending stick is knocked away from him. The goaltender has no stick. Now he'll get a defenseman stick. Puck is cleared out to center. And still without the stick. So with the defenseman stick, that means Phil Edwards will go to the bench. They get a new player on the ice. No goaltending stick yet. And with 19:29 to go in the period, it is still off to the corner, and the Ice Bears, though, can't take advantage of it. Puck up the middle, it's deflected away. Still, the goaltender does not, Heron does not want to risk going all the way to the left faceoff circle to try to get the goaltending stick. So he'll wait and hold on. The players cannot touch it either. Puck at the red line. Robert Morris still with possession. Into Keith Parker. He'll let it go to Andrew Fugner. Fugner gets it up to Hummy. Hummy banks it off the boards. Gannon is there. Puck is deflected to the corner. You know, if you're Heron, you desperately want a stoppage in play. It's not happening. Puck comes in, it hits the goaltender's stick as somehow, I think he got help from the referee who sent it right in front to him. Play continues. Now they swap sticks, and the goaltender, Heron, has his goaltending stick back with 18:22 to go in the period. Leslie with it. Leslie tried to get it behind the net. Now the referee picks up that errant stick. It'll go to the point. It is underneath the stick of Fontana. Back into the Missouri State zone, no icing. 18:18 remains in the period. 2-1, Robert Morris. Ice Bears with a goal by Brandon Olson, Sam Milligan, and Nick Bussey with goals for Robert Morris. Now we get a drive in, and it's stopped by Heron and a save. Where we have pushing and shoving, 18:07 to go in the period, and maybe some penalties.
Well, to start off this period, Missouri State going with their fourth line to try and get some energy going. I really think Tyler Overman got away with shoving Heron out of the way. He legitimately went out of his way, put his arm out, and knocked Heron, which is the reason why the stick ended so far away from where it was. Fortunately for him, Missouri State, that they didn't get a penalty, and unfortunately for Robert Morris, Missouri State couldn't take advantage and get any pressure in the offensive zone.
Absolutely none when the goaltender was without his stick. Puck in, save by Heron. He'll take the rebound himself. Now he has authority. And watch out. This may have sparked Heron a little bit. Yankee at the blue line. Dug out by Chris Peake. Poked away from him. Stuck to the corner. And coming in to help out is Dylan Durham. He's pushed off the play for Robert Morris and finally jabs it out to center. Two more shots credited Missouri State. Here's Yankee with a shot in that's partially tipped into the corner off the stick of Doblier. It'll go to the near side. That's actually, no, John O'Neville, 20, not 10. Neville with control now for Robert Morris. Behind the net to Sam Milligan. Milligan with a hard shot, sweeps it around off of the referee. It nicked off the referee, and he's holding his knee for that one. The puck is into the zone of Robert Morris. The Ice Bears with a line change. Cordy will come to check out. Far side board, 17:01 to go in the period. 2-1 Robert Morris. Now Dylan Durham, 5 goals for him this season. Puck is sent in, and Sarah Sable will have control. Well, earlier, Dan, I had mentioned that the honorary idea for the Coyotes wingman of the game right now, I would vote for Troy Cordy.
I think he's had a good game. Obviously, Olsen getting his first goal of the year, a nice little one at that, has a shot as well, but they have to get something going offensively. Maybe somebody can try to take that honorable mention away as this game wears down.
16:34 to go in the period. Ice Bears trail by 1. Cordy to put a check on Cole Metzler. Now coming in is Jacob Schwier, dug out by the Ice Bears. Cordy swung around, far side boards. It is underneath the stick of Fugner, and he'll chase it back in his own zone. Line change for both teams. Partial one for Missouri State, full for Robert Morris, with the exception of Edwards, and Edwards is out now. A full change for Missouri State. Tipped ahead. Chasing it is Doblier, but stepping in front of him is Stephen Fontaine of Missouri State. Now off the boards, push from behind is Ranieri. No penalty. Play continues. The goaltender, Heron, comes out. Again, swipes it over to the corner to Edwards. Now with control for Robert Morris. Doblier lost it. Here comes Fontana. Threw a couple of skates and a sliding Edwards that slid over Fontana. We come the other way. 2-on-2 into the zone. Brandon Neville shot that gets deflected high and wide. And we get a whistle and a stoppage and play. Faceoff as Doblier ran into the goaltender. So we'll have a faceoff with 15:27 to go in the third period. And a 2-1 lead for Robert Morris Peoria.
And if you're Fontana there, a little bit of trouble with his skates trying to get around the Robert Morris defense. Trying to see if he could cycle the puck across ice, just loses an edge and lost the puck along with it. Could have been a terrific chance, but no dice for Missouri State still early in this third period.
Far side boards, puck now sent behind the net to Yankee. Duran Yankee for Missouri State. Ice Bears looking to break a 3-on-2. They can't do it. It's too far off the stick of Ranieri. And Jono Neville, he'll clear it out to center for Robert Morris. Ice Bears looking to get control, but Neville has it through some skates and it's out to center. Ice Bears quickly move it along to Mario Sanchez off of his skate, now in front of the Robert Morris bench. And for a moment there, I thought it was four Robert Morris players fighting. Now there's a battle for it. And that one Ice Bear was Mike Hummey. He pushes them away. Play stays in the zone. Dug out, taken by Leslie. Ice Bears with no pressure, except Ranieri comes in to chase it behind the net. 14:33 to go in the period. Leslie to the bench.
It was a long shift for that top line. They needed to get off.
Neville with a drive in and a save by Parker. When I looked over to the bench, I saw three Eagles battling.
Yeah, it was 3-on-1.
And for a moment there, you couldn't see any white. I was wondering what they were doing in the corner there, or right in front of the bench. Play continues at center. And Schwier will send it off the boards and back down to the Missouri State zone, where it'll be chased by Joe Doblier. Doblier pushed by Duran Yankee of Missouri State. Far side boards now taken by the Ice Bears and Drew Sturm. Sturm will get it out to center. Now look for an opportunity for Brandon Olsen to bring it across. And a huge hit by Chris Peek. He put one on Eric Ostervix. And it's Doblier in the zone. He shoots and a save by Parker. He'll hold on. Shots even up. Well, they might give him a shot there, so it might be 24-23 in favor of Robert Morris. But at any rate, it is a 2-1 lead in favor of the Eagles, too.
Well, that shot might have been going wide, too, though, Steve. Parker not taking any risks there, because as we've seen from about the beginning of the second period on, once Robert Morris is able to gain access to that offensive zone, they usually stay there for quite a bit.
Play in the Robert Morris zone. 13-29 to go in the period. 2-1 lead, Robert Morris. Matt Deluski having trouble with the puck, and it's past Ryan Gannon. So Sarah Sable will slap it off the boards and the glass, and Robert Morris will regain control. Eagles, 12-10 on the season. Missouri State Ice Bears, 18-8-1. And that includes a couple of losses to Arkansas and a couple of losses to Lindenwood Belleville. And quite frankly, the Ice Bears played pretty well in those games until late in the third period. Puck deflected back by Cole Metzler into the Missouri State zone. No icing. Parker to stop it there. 12 3/4 to go in the third period. Ice Bears trail by one. Here's a lead. It'll go to Cordy off of a glove, so there's no icing. Cordy avoids the check of Jono Neville. It'll go to the near side. Now to Hummy, and he lost it off of his stick as the Ice Bears are trying to get something going. Hummy can't pick it up. Sam Milliken races in right side. He got a shot off and a save by Parker. May have been going wide by Milliken, but at any rate, Parker still had to make the save. Shots are now even up at 23-23, 12-16 to go in the period. 2-1 lead. Underneath Leslie's stick, and he had it at the blue line. Sent back by Schwartz in the Missouri State zone. He'll have to chase down his own pass. Now here is Schwartz again. Gets it out of harm's way up the slot to Sean Leslie. Now to the left side. It'll go to Tyler Ranieri. He'll swing it in. Stopped by the goaltender, Cam Herron. To the corner now. Leslie with a turnaround shot. Save. Rebound. Hummy shot in into the midsection of Herron. The first good opportunity for Missouri State. And now we get pushing as Doublier pushes the Ice Bear Sean Leslie. And I think we're going to get one, maybe two, or just one.
I thought Leslie was going to go off, but Doublier hitting Leslie, I think Leslie kind of got away with one as he tried hooking one of the Eagles players after the whistle was blown. But it is, as it always seems the case in this sport, the retaliatory penalty is the one that gets called. But at any point in the game, you got to keep a level head. With Mike Hummy, got a little frustrated as he lost the puck going outside the offensive zone. And it almost looked like he was trying to slam his stick in frustration. He wasn't able to get back in time. And Milliken walked away with the breakaway. Luckily for him, he didn't get a great shot off, but fortunately for Missouri State, a power play that they desperately need to get something going on.
Off the draw, the puck is cleared into the Missouri State zone, and the Ice Bears with a great opportunity to tie this game up. They trail right now 2-1. They had a 1-0 lead in this game, and two unanswered goals by Robert Morris. Puck is sent wide and out of the zone, and that's where the Ice Bears are undisciplined. They have it set up, and immediately it's killed by clearing it outside the zone. 1:27 to go in the power play. 1:09 remaining in the third period. Again, Maka implications for these two teams who both have 6-0 or 6 wins on the season. The Ice Bears are undefeated. Robert Morris is 6-1. Shot and a save by Parker. Now Milliken winds up, and another shot. This one sticked to side off the skate of Fugner, and the puck is stolen. It's Bussey who had it, hopped over his stick, and Ryan Gannon will control it for Missouri State. Precious penalty time off the clock for Robert Morris as the Ice Bears still fail to get anything set up. They'll move it in the zone. Now it is Brandon Olson. It tipped away from him and is cleared out to center. May confuse you on live TV as he is wearing an old jersey with Green's name on it. Here's a drive in. Olson with a deflection. Now Fontana drops it in low, taken away and cleared all the way down. 25 seconds remaining. Shots are even up at 24 apiece. Approaching 10 minutes remaining in the third period. Here is Cordy. Cordy steps around Jacob Schwier. Cordy looking in front. Still with it. Power play has 3 seconds. Here's Gannon. Gets it to Cordy. Right face off. Now to the left side. Here is a drive that's partially blocked. Cordy looking for the backhander. Coming in off the ice is Doublier, and he cannot get control of it. It's slapped away from him and sent down behind to Olson. Olsen lost control of it. Blake Maxwell to clear it for Robert Morris to Doblier. He'll get it out of harm's way. Doblier to the bench. Line change for Robert Morris. Ice Bears move it up quickly across the line. Gannon couldn't get around Blake Maxwell. Lead pass off the stick of Nick Bussey back down to the Missouri State zone. Full line change for Robert Morris. Ice Bears have yet to do that. Now they'll move it up the ice and do that line change on the back end. Here comes Stephen Fontana. Gets a shot that's partially blocked. It'll go to the corner, and it's out to center. Once again, it'll come to Bussey. He'll swing it around where it's intercepted by Missouri State and Drew Sturm. Sturm out of St. Louis, Missouri, 4 goals this season. Make that 5. And the corner, Leslie, high slot. Now drops it to the left side. Checked off the play is Ranieri. 8:34 to go in the period. Sturm coming in. Sturm will have his puck deflected by Sam Milligan. He'll clear it out to center. Underneath the stick of Cole Metzler, and we have an icing call.
I'm not sure you can say much else about the defenseman for Robert Morris today. Absolutely no room for Missouri State to try getting the puck deep, especially in this period. Got to give credit to guys like Maxwell and Neville just taking off, forcing the play to the outside, and when the play is there, Missouri State has absolutely nothing to do with the puck. Robert Morris will call a timeout here.
Yeah, they'll take that timeout to discuss things. Tell you what, we'll take a quick timeout too. It is 2-1, Robert Morris over Missouri State. 8:24 to go in this third period.
Pearson Kelly Office Products presents
Great Moments in Office Technology.
When Julie gets bored at work, she writes funny captions to pictures of animals she found online. Then she realized she could send all of her pictures in one gigantic message to her coworkers. At that moment, Julie created Junk Email. Now, employees can enjoy their days watching auto-tuned sneezing pandas. There are plenty of ways to waste your company's money. Your copier shouldn't be one of them. Pearson Kelly Office Products. Business made simple.
.24 remains in the third period, and as you mentioned, Robert Morris bottling up Missouri State, forcing the play to the outside. The Ice Bears have had just a handful of good opportunities down the middle and in the slot area. Good defense by the Robert Morris Eagles. Now off the draw, the Ice Bears have it again. Sarasebo shoots and it goes wide. Chasing it is Olsen. Olsen can't get the puck as it's cleared over the jumping and leaping Andrew Fugner, but we get an icing call. So a positive in that respect. The Ice Bears will do it again in the Robert Morris zone.
Not really an offensive period by both teams, combining for only 6 shots, 3 apiece. It's evened up at 24 apiece as well with 8:13 remaining. But for Missouri State, you got to up your aggressiveness a little bit here on the forecheck. See if you can get something going offensively.
Maybe hit the body a little bit too and get things created.
That's something that neither team has done all that well.
Another icing call, so we'll do it again. But the key though is Missouri State is not winning the faceoffs.
And that's another
icing. And we're going to have faceoff at center ice.
Because there's always seems to be a habit. I think Parker keeps going out of the net on these icing plays before the referee, or just after the referee realizes to blow the whistle, and obviously that could have helped Missouri State with a faceoff in the offensive zone. But
yeah, I think Jim Sanchez finally said something to the officials as they let it go 2 or 3 times. Play stays onside to Sarasebo on the left, on the right side. She shoots, save, rebound loose, and it's covered by Heron.
Well, at this point of the game, I think that's the right mindset for Missouri State. Just throw something on net and see if something happens. Not a lot of offense in this period, just to make Heron think a little bit more than he has to, because he hasn't faced a lot of shots in this period or in this game.
Leslie to take the draw from Tyler, or Frank, that Brandon Neville. Puck is down to the Missouri State zone. Sabo to chase. Puck is deflected by Bussey. And The Ice Bears will have to get control again. Robert Morris doing everything well at the neutral ice and still trying to bottle up Missouri State in their own defensive end. Ice Bears not able to get much by way of shot opportunities. Puck stolen, though. Hummy up the middle, intercepted, taken by Bussey, and a go to the far side. Held in by Fontana. He'll bank it off to the corner, and it's off the stick of Tyler Ranieri to the near side. Puck stays in. Leslie with it. Leslie up the middle, broken up by Cole Metzler. Now Hummy around Metzler's check. Hummy swings it around. Nobody for Missouri State. Ranieri will go for it and chase it. Ranieri will give it to Leslie. Now Scott Leslie up the middle. Hummy with a blast, and it goes wide. Near side, taken by the defense. It's Matt Deluski. Cannot clear it for Robert Morris. Held in, and a bouncer by Hummy is covered by Heron.
But a little bit more offensive pressure for Missouri State, able to keep the puck in the offensive zone. All really have to do here, get a big faceoff win and try to keep up the pressure. They've gotten a couple more hits the last couple of shifts. Unfortunately, just have to move the puck to the right spot and see if something will happen.
Ryan Gannon in to take the draw from Bernicke. Puck is loose. Jones with an opportunity. Cordy is with his stick held. Now right side, Gannon drive and a save from the left side. Here is Fontana. He shoots. It's partially blocked. Schwartz with an opportunity. It's blocked again. Great job by not only Durham, but Cameron Bernicke to block the puck on two successive attempts. Cordy is hooked, nothing doing. Puck comes to the right side, not able to be held in by Schwartz. The Ice Bears have to regroup. Sent in offside, and Missouri State will now flood the zone. Cordy, the only one in. 5:56 remaining in the period. Puck banked in front of the Robert Morris bench, now to the Ice Bears bench. Eagles with control. It'll go to Dylan Durham. He'll send it in, and a line change for Robert Morris. Shots 27-24 in favor of Missouri State. Puck is partially tipped, and the Ice Bears fail to break it out once again. But they do somehow get control of the puck and sweep it in off of Ranieri's stick. Goaltender Heron lets it go. Far side boards. Banked off. Now in front of the Missouri State bench. It is cleared back into the Robert Morris end. 5:24 to go in the period. Steve Kasson, Dan Dowell, thanks for joining us. Don't forget that we'll have a continual broadcast of the Ice Bears Division II game against Illinois. That's coming up here at 7:00. Hope you'll stay tuned for that. Here is a lead pass to Ranieri across the line to Leslie. Leslie looks for a backhand opportunity. He is taken out of the play by Milligan. Now getting help from Ronnie Crockett. Also in is Jono Neville for Robert Morris. A blast in pad save as a shot from Mario Sanchez on the left side was saved by Heron. One of the better attempts for Missouri State. Here's Walensky looking for the behind. We're going to get a penalty, and it's going to go against Missouri State. 4:36 as Walensky came behind the net. We're going to get a penalty against the Ice Bears. And with 4:36 to go, Missouri State will have to kill the penalty. I think Duran Yankee's going in.
Yeah, not an opportune time for a penalty here as Missouri State was able to get a little bit of offensive pressure there. Not a lot, and really, Steve, I think you've kind of noticed it as well. More wrist shots from the point. Sanchez with one of the few slap shots. Really, the only reason why Robert Morris has had all these blocks is because Missouri State hasn't been able to get any mustard on their wristers.
Clearing pass, and Gannon comes in. It's swept away by Heron. So a power play for Robert Morris. Opponents coming in. 19.5%, 24 power play goals for 123 opportunities. 4:11 remaining, 1:34 to go in the period. Robert Morris with control. Through the slot, it's Milligan. He'll go to the right side. Now get it to Neville. Back to Milligan, a shot high and wide. Goes to Bernicke. Cameron Bernicke will get it to Milligan once again. Neville, Brandon Neville. Waits for a return pass from the left side, but it's intercepted. And out of the zone momentarily was Troy Cordy, where it'll come to Zach Bunce. Line change for Missouri State, partially on the defense. Now that'll give Brandon Neville an opportunity to tip it in off the stick of Jono Neville. It'll go to the far side. Stays on for Neville. Here's a break. Trying to chase it down is Leslie. He is upended. Penalty.
He's going to get both of them, Steve. Both of them holding each other up. Initially, I thought it was only going to be Leslie. But I think it's fortunately for him that both of them are going to go.
Well, originally I thought the penalty was going to go against Robert Morris. And I think if Leslie would have let his hands go,
yeah,
he might not have been called.
I think the smart thing there would just try, because the puck was in the general vicinity of the Eagles player. I think if he would have just maybe tried nudging him off the puck, Leslie's not the biggest man on the planet, and a lot of size advantage for Robert Morris on their bench. If they could have just, if he could have just maybe just nudged him off the puck, probably wouldn't have been a call on either person.
And because of that, they will be coincidental minors. They will not go on the scoreboard, so we're still 5-on-4 for 44 seconds, the fifth power play. Take that back. It is the third power play for the Eagles.
And unfortunately for Missouri State, Leslie's one of their top offensive guys. And as we saw last weekend against McKendree, had a shorthanded goal to tie the game on a 5-minute major to send the game inevitably into overtime.
42 seconds now remains. Ryan Gannon in to take the draw from Cameron Bernicke. And Bernicke's won the draw usually, but he doesn't hear. Hummy lost it. Here comes a break, potentially for Bussey, but he has to get control of the puck. The Ice Bears get back. Now it'll go to Milligan. A blast in score. What can you say about Sam Milligan's shot?
It's very, very hard and very, very lethal. And if you're going to leave him with that much space at any point in the ice, you have to make sure there's a man on him, because that puck goes in at least 50% of the time. Just a huge blast by Milligan on the left or the right faceoff circle from our vantage point. But a huge blast beats Parker on the glove side. And Robert Morris gets a two-goal lead for the first time today.
16th goal for Sam Milligan. That is a power play goal. And it is 3-1 Robert Morris. We'll catch the call from Tim Greasy in a moment on the assist. Meanwhile, Ice Bears will move it into the Robert Morris zone. Duran Yankee cut off at the pass. Now Bussey will have it. Another lead opportunity for Bernicke. He gets around two defense. Bernicke walks in all alone. He shoots, and a save by Parker. So the Ice Bears
Robert
defense
Morris,
breaking
power play
down.
Goal scorer number 44, Sam Milligan, assisted by number 40, Nick Bussey, and number 6, Cam Bernicke. Milligan from Bussey and Bernicke. Time of the goal, 16:54.
So 3-1 in favor of Robert Morris, and the Ice Bears now trail by two, who had led this game at least by a count of 1-0 after the first period. 2:12 remaining in the period. And the puck is cleared all the way down to the Robert Morris zone. Well, you saw it towards the tail end of the second period. Things starting to slow down, and Missouri State not getting good opportunities. And that carried on here into the third period. So Robert Morris doing what they needed to do, and they lead by two. Puck banked off the glass, held in. Here's Sturm looking in front as Hummy. Sturm shot high and wide. It'll go to the far side. Fugner chased down by Sturm. Can't get it away from the stick check. Brandon Neville, he'll send it in. Sarah Sable on the ice for Missouri State. And Sable will set things up. 1:30 to go. Gets it quickly to Ranieri. Across the line, delayed offside for Robert Morris. Cleared out to center. Sabo to send it ahead. Taken by Phil Edwards. Edwards for Robert Morris. Eagles will get it into the Ice Bears zone, where Parker will stop it there. Along the shelf of the boards, it stays in. And tipped ahead, but off of Fugner's stick. Sent back down to the Missouri State zone. Line change for both teams. Less than a minute remaining in the third period. Another blast by Milligan. This one sails high and wide. 54 seconds remains. Robert Morris will come away with a split here against the number 9 ranked Missouri State. Here comes Ryan Gannon. Gannon right side, in front, shot, save, rebound, loose, as Steve Fontana got the opportunity, and a big save there. Gannon tried to push it ahead. The goaltender still in the nets. Here's Cordy, he shoots, and a blocker save. Far side boards, Ice Bears keep the goaltender in. Here's Schwartz, he winds, and a glove save by Heron. He'll hold on.
With the stoppage, I'd expect Missouri State to pull Parker to get another opportunity, but I'm kind of surprised with as much pressure as they had in the last 30 seconds, which really was the most pressure they've had in a couple periods, why they wouldn't try pulling him with the two-goal deficit.
So a face-off with 25.3 seconds remaining. That'll be the right of Heron. And off the draw, the Ice Bears win it again. Ranieri has it tipped away from Bernicke. And a drive in behind the net. Leslie will try to pick it up. 15 seconds remain. Far side. Bussey's there to disrupt the play. Bernicke will have it for Robert Morris. Clear it out. No, it stays in. Here's a wobbler off of the stick of Fugner, and that'll do it for the third period. So the Robert Morris Eagles come in and they take a split from Missouri State. 3-1 the final score. As you see, the Eagles congratulating Cam Heron. Come up with several key saves in the third period. One most notably on a blast from Mario Sanchez from the left point that he just got his left toe out on.
Valuable player of the game, Brandon Olson, will receive a gift certificate to Bears Sports Grills with three Springfield locations, including just south of MediaCom Ice Park.
So they have given the Bears MVP to Brandon Olson. Our vote for MVP would have been who?
Probably the same, because that was the only offensive production they got today.
Again, outshooting the opponent, 31-26 was Missouri State, but they lose the game 3-1. Brandon Olson does get the first goal for the Ice Bears back in the first period at 5:32. Chris Peek and Drew Sturm with the assists. Then in the second at 15:40, Robert Morris and Sam Milligan is 15th. The assists go to John O'Neville and to Cole Metzler to make it a 1-1 game. Just about 4 minutes later, Robert Morris's Nick Bussey, his ninth, Sam Milligan, and Brandon Neville with the assists. It's a 2-1 game. Then in the third, on a power play with 3:06 remaining in the third period, Sam Milligan, 16th, on a blast from the right point. The assists go to Nick Bussey and to Cameron Bernicke, and that's where things end up. Power plays, the Ice Bears 0-4-5. The Eagles 1-3, and again, that big power play late in the game seals the deal for Robert Morris. Missouri State falls to 8-9-1. Robert Morris is 13-10 on the season. And again, you got to look at the way that Robert Morris played the third period and really how they adjusted and took away really some passing lanes and some shooting lanes from Missouri State.
Yeah, they weren't really concerned with the offense necessarily, only having four or five shots in that period, but able to make the adjustment, play a defensive style of hockey, and really take advantage of them, especially with the late goal there to finally put it away. But for Missouri State, Steve, I think the biggest question is, obviously they'll have to have a big win tomorrow against Bradley, but will this loss inevitably hurt them in the long run, because there's quite a bit of separation between the 9-10, 11-12 spot in the Pacific Division for the rankings, on top of the fact that due to points, Missouri State was only 2 points out of the 8 spot in Nebraska. So we'll see where this ends up. Hopefully it won't cost them too much.
I think you have to get a win from Bradley tomorrow, and I think they will be okay at least to stay in the top 10, but it remains to be seen because the voters will have their say in about a week or so. But once again, the final score as the Ice Bears, well, they lose this game by a score of 3-1. Quite frankly, a game that they could have won had they put the pedal to the metal late in the period. I'm Steve Cassin for Dan Dell. Thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned. The D2 coming up.
You've been listening to Missouri State Ice Bears Hockey with your host, Steve Cassin. Thank you for tuning in to tonight's game. Ice Bears Hockey is a presentation of DS Sports Enterprises and WebSportsRadio.com.